From studios at the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, this is Fourth and State. In this edition, John Schlifske, the chief executive at Northwestern Mutual, discusses the company's proposed new office tower downtown. Hi, I'm David Haynes. I'm the opinions editor at the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, and I'm joined today on Fourth and State by John Schlifske, who is the chief executive at Northwestern Mutual. John, welcome.
Thanks.
Thanks for being here. So you have some exciting news. The company has decided to build a new office tower on the site of a current building, a building built in the late 70s. I think you affectionately call it the Brown Building.
Right.
That would come down. Why don't you explain what will happen once that comes down?
Well, we expect that building to be fully down by the end of 2014. And what we received approval from our board yesterday and what we announced is the construction of a 800,000 to 850,000 square foot office building on that site, probably be about 30 to 35 floors. Mm-hmm. And it will house not only the employees that are in that the building that's coming down now, that's about 1,100 employees, but it'll also provide growth for our company to take on another maybe 1,700 extra employees or additional employees over the next decade or so. Mm-hmm. So it's a building that's not only replacing the one we have, but allows us to grow downtown in downtown Milwaukee.
Mm-hmm. And talk a little bit about design. We just had an editorial board where we talked some about that. Design has become, in Milwaukee, a much more important factor in building, especially in the downtown area, than it was some years ago. You have some very sort of definite goals for the building in terms of how it looks.
Right. I mean, we want the design to be iconic in the nature that when people look at it, it conveys to them what Northwestern Mutual is. AAA rated company that's relevant, vibrant, and growing. So the design is really important in getting that image of the company out there. But we also recognize that site is right at the base of Wisconsin Avenue, and there's so many interesting architectural things down there, the Calatrava, Pure Wisconsin. And so whatever we design has to fit in. We want it to not only be iconic, but something that sort of fits in with the rest of the architecture on the lakefront there. And then lastly, we want it to be something that we're all proud of. At the end of the day, we want people, both employees, policy owners, but also anybody who lives in Milwaukee to look at that building and say, I'm glad that's in Milwaukee.
And will NML occupy the entire building?
We expect to occupy the entire building, right? That the size that we're building will be entirely for our own employees.
Okay. I think Mayor Barrett said that this would be the biggest building project downtown since the 70s. A building that's large should have some catalytic effect. I know this isn't your business, but what do you expect to happen around it once the building is fully occupied?
Well, we expect it to help spur on the development of the lakefront. There's a great lakefront development plan that's being circulated, mm-hmm. that people are working on, and we support that. We know that not only do our employees work there, but we bring in thousands of business visitors to our campus every year, and this will just increase that. Of course, they need places to stay, they need places to eat, they oftentimes need social activities. So we think the building will have a halo effect on the development of the east end of Wisconsin Avenue.
And talk a bit about the city's role here. The city is being asked, or will be asked, to create what would be the largest TIF district, tax incremental financing district, that it's ever created. I think it's $48 million. Let's get that right. Talk a bit about the city's role and how that factored into your decision.
Well, as soon as we started thinking about where we were going to build, we knew that building downtown was more expensive for us. It's more expensive because it just is more expensive to build high-rise office buildings, but also there's a lot of infrastructure issues at that end of the avenue that
steam
make it,
tunnels
steam
and so
tunnels
forth underneath
groundwater make it more expensive to build there. And so as our primary responsibility is as a fiduciary to our policy owners, and we knew we didn't have a blank check. And as soon as we knew we wanted to build downtown, we started working with the city to see if there was a way that they could help offset some of the costs of the construction through a TIF district. And I really have to hand it to the city development people for being creative. We've come up with a package that not only gives us the economic value that we need to justify the cost of building downtown, but it is done in such a creative way that our property tax payments to the city of Milwaukee go up every year. They never go down. So even in the beginning construction area, end of this, there's no shortfall from a city budget perspective. So I think it's a win-win for both parties.
Mm-hmm. And the mayor explained that a portion of the increment actually will go to infrastructure nearby, or redirecting some of the streets, which might create more development.
Right.
How many jobs how many people are employed at NML now downtown total?
Right now downtown it's about 3,500, and then we have another 1,100 to 1,500 out at Franklin.
Okay, and you expect over the next decade to have maybe another 1,700 or so, I think.
Right, that's right. We expect about 1,700 additional employees downtown over the next 10 years, plus or minus. And that sort of reflects the growth that we have as a company going on right now. But it's also in line with our historical growth patterns around employment.
One final question. I know you looked at expanding in Franklin, and in some ways in a suburban area, it's easier. What was it that tipped the scales in favor of staying downtown?
Well, first of all, we have a commitment to Milwaukee. We like being headquartered here. We like having our work environment downtown Milwaukee, and we really wanted to try to make it work downtown. We still expect to grow out in Franklin, but at the end of the day, this is such a great piece of real estate. The ability to put up an office tower there that serves not only our employees, our policy owners in the city of Milwaukee, just became our number one goal.
Well, thanks, John Schlifsky, CEO at Northwestern Mutual, and good luck on the new building.
All right, thanks a lot. Appreciate it.